What's going on, guys? Welcome to the video. What you guys are seeing right now is my back and biceps workout from last night, which it was kind of funny because I didn't have anybody to record for me, so I had a tripod and I was going to record myself, but I don't like recording myself when there's a lot of people in the gym. So what I did was I waited till it was really late. I think it was like 11:30 at night, and I went to the gym hoping there would be nobody there. There were like three cars there, and I literally sat in my car for about a half an hour waiting for everybody to leave, and then just when the last person was about to leave, another person showed up. It was really frustrating because I really wanted to record a workout, but I was almost kind of close to just saying screw it and not even recording the workout. But I was determined to record this workout. So what I did was I went to another Anytime Fitness location, because I don't know if you guys know this, but Anytime Fitness, if you're a member, you get to go to all the locations around the world. So I went to another Anytime Fitness location about 15 minutes away, and thank God no one was there. So I went inside, started recording the workout, and I started working out, and then a person walked in and saw me with the tripod, saw me recording my workout, and it was kind of awkward. But at this point, I wasn't gonna not record my workout. It was already past midnight at this point, and I was really determined. So I just said, screw it, you know, he can look at me weird, I really don't care. He gave me a few weird looks and then went on about his workout for about 20 minutes. And then about halfway through his workout, I guess, he kind of walked up to me and took out his earphones. So I kind of got the gist that he wanted to talk to me. So I took out my earphones as well. And I already knew what he was wondering. He wanted to know why I was recording my workout. So before he even said anything, before he even asked a question, I just told him that I had a YouTube channel, and I told him why I was recording my workout. I told him the type of videos I like to upload. He thought the whole YouTube channel thing was really cool. He wasn't like mean about it. He wasn't weird about it. He didn't make fun of me. It was actually a really good experience. And those type of experiences make me want to tell more people about my YouTube channel in the future. And that kind of brings me into the next thing that I wanted to talk about. And I don't know if you guys know this. If you're a new subscriber, you probably don't know this, but I started out making gaming videos. I haven't always been a fitness YouTuber, a vlogger. I started out making gaming videos and commentaries, and that's why my name is the Couch Potato. If you didn't know this, then you probably never really understood why my name is the Couch Potato when I upload fitness videos. It doesn't really coincide, doesn't really fit. But lately I've been thinking a lot, and I'm pretty sure I've decided that I'm going to change my name to just my regular name, Blake Bolgiano. I just decided that since I'm going in the direction of fitness and vlogs and lifestyle videos on my YouTube channel, that it would be more fitting if I had my name rather than a corny name like the Couch Potato. So as soon as I can get some extra money, as soon as I can afford to pay someone to get some more channel art, a new banner and a new logo, then as soon as I get that, I'm going to change my name to Blake Bolgiano. So if you see a video that looks like it might be mine and the name is Blake Bolgiano, please click on it, guys. I don't want you guys to get confused and think I like deleted my YouTube channel or anything. I don't want you guys to just stop watching my videos altogether because I changed my name and you don't know who I am. So I'm letting you know ahead of time that I'm changing my name pretty soon, so be on the lookout for that. I haven't really talked about the workout that much in this commentary, but as always, the workout is obviously up on the screen and it will always be in the description. I tried so hard to find a stringer to wear to this workout because a stringer shows more of your back than a tank top does. I don't know if you guys know what a stringer is. It basically just comes in more narrow on your back. I wanted to wear that so you guys could see a better view of my back when I was doing a back workout, but I looked really hard, couldn't find it in the laundry. I guess it was just dirty or something. So I had to settle for a tank top. That's the end of this commentary. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. You can try this back workout if you want, and I will see you guys in the rest of the video.
Just got off from the gym. I'm whispering because everyone's sleeping. I'm about to drink a protein shake and go take some flexing pics for the thumbnail and for Instagram. I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Just woke up, guys. These stairs are so freaking steep, and coming down these stairs when I'm so half asleep in the morning is not the funnest thing in the world. Check this out, guys. Come over here in the storage closet. Look at all of these freaking supplements, dude. I have this whole tub full of BPI Sports supplements. I have protein, pre-workout, BCAAs, all kinds of stuff. I think it's safe to say I won't be needing to buy supplements for a while. Thank you, BPI Sports. Really generous to me. But I think I'm gonna get my day started with some Hurricane Orange Aminos with Energy. Don't forget, guys, I just got a discount code with BPI Sports, so if you want anything from the BPI Sports website, you can use code BBOLGIANO. It's always in the description, but I'll put it up on the screen right now. BBOLGIANO to get 20% off your entire purchase. Excuse me looking like a zombie, but while on the topic of supplements, I just wanna talk about something regarding supplements that I've kind of been noticing lately. It seems like a lot of beginners, when they first start working out, they feel the need to take all of these supplements in order to get big. They think they need to take a bunch of stuff. I know several people, including my friends and just random people that I know, that when they first start working out or they wanna get back into working out after not a long time working out, they'll get on a pro hormone or they'll get on a testosterone booster or maybe even a SARM
if you guys know what that is. And honestly, guys, if you're looking to work out for the first time and you're just getting into it, you really don't need a lot of supplements. Yes, supplements do work and they can do some good for you, but in the long run, they can do more bad for you than good for you. So just to give you guys an idea, I'm gonna show you guys what I take, because a lot of people would consider me to have a, you know, decent physique working out and stuff. I look okay, you know? And a lot of people think you have to take supplements to look how I do. Not saying I look like amazing or anything, but some people would look at a person with the physique that I have and think that you need to take all kinds of stuff, and you really don't need to, guys. So out of all the supplements in the world, there's really only one that's like absolutely necessary if you want to build muscle, you want to grow muscle. And that one supplement that is absolutely necessary is protein. The reason protein is the only supplement that's necessary is because after your workout, in the workout you're pretty much destroying your muscle, and then after your workout you need protein to rebuild it in order to gain muscle. And of course you might be wondering, well, can't you just get protein in food? Well, of course you can, but eating food, it takes a lot longer to digest, takes a lot longer for the protein to absorb and go to your muscles. So if you have the money and you want to take a pre-workout, you can. Like this one from BPI Sports. It's not necessary, but a lot of people do like to take pre-workout to give them that extra energy before a workout. A couple other things you can take if you want. You can take a fish oil. If you don't eat a lot of fish already, it's gonna take a fish oil for bone health and heart health and all that good stuff. And then you can also take a multivitamin if you don't feel like you get your vitamins in your food. Those things aren't really necessary. They're only if you don't get in your diet and you have the extra money. Really, guys, if you want to build muscle, the only thing that's necessary, like I said, is protein. About to make some breakfast, guys. Not really sure what I'm gonna make. Probably gonna make some eggs, maybe some bread with it to make an egg sandwich. We'll see. Here's breakfast, guys. Got 7 whole eggs with salt and pepper on top. Decided to cut up some strawberries to go with it. And I'm still sipping on my BPI Sports aminos with energy.
Truth. I hope we don't fade away. I hope we don't go to waste when we're in Cali.